These two points are inside the circle, this point is on the circle, and this point is outside the circle. Great work if you got all four of them correct. Now, if you weren't sure where to start, let's look at this first point and see why it's on the circle. Then you might be able to figure out why these are inside and this one's outside. Remember that this is really just a right triangle in space. It has some horizontal distance x and some vertical distance y. So we want to be sure that when we plug in the values for x, like negative 6, and the value of y, like positive 8, we get 100. So squaring negative 6 and squaring 8, we'll get 36 plus 64, which equals 100. So yes, it turns out that this statement is true. This means that the point negative 6, 8 is a point on our circle, since it satisfies the equation. We also know that this point is on our circle, since we can set up a right triangle. The point negative 6, 8 is 6 units left from the origin and 8 units up. If we use the Pythagorean theorem here, we'll discover that this side, or this radius, is 10. This should also make sense because we really have a 3, 4, 5 triangle. The triangle has just been multiplied by 2 to give us a 6, 8, 10 triangle. So we know that the distance from the origin to this point is 10 units. And that matches with our idea that any point on our circle is 10 units from the center. So by checking the point in our calculations, or by drawing out a diagram, we can know that this point is definitely on our circle. For this point, it turns out it will be inside. When we check the point negative 9, 4, we'll plug in x with the value of negative 9, and we'll substitute the value of y with 4. Simplifying the left-hand side of our equation, we'll get 97. We know that's not equal to 100, and in fact, this is less than 100. Since negative 9 squared plus 4 squared equals 97, we really know that we're inside the circle. Remember that 10 is the radius of our circle. It's the square root of this number. So this means the distance from the origin to this point is the square root of 97, which is definitely less than 10. The right triangle for this point would look like this. We'd have 9 units to the left of the origin, and then 4 units up. This point would just be shy of reaching our circle. We know that the distance from the origin to this point is the square root of 97. It's the square root of this number. We really want this distance to be 10, or the square root of 100, and it's not. It's less than that. So that's how we know this point is inside the circle. The same would be true for the point 7, negative 7. If we plug in x with the value of 7 and y with the value of negative 7, we'll get the statement 98 equals 100. This isn't true, so we know that the distance from the origin to this point is less than 10. So this point must be inside. And finally, for this point, when we plug in x with the value of 5 and y with the value of 9, we'll get 106 equal to 100. This isn't true, and we know 106 is greater than 100. That means that the distance of 5, 9 from the origin is greater than 10. The point 5, 9 would be just outside of our circle. We can even see this on Desmos. Here's the equation of our circle, and we can see that the point negative 6, 8 is on it. Even if we zoom in, we can quickly see that yes, the point is on the circle. And then this other point, negative 9, 4, isn't. It's just slightly inside of our circle. The other point that we said was inside the circle is 7, negative 7, this point down here. Zooming in on this region, we see that it's just shy of being on the circle. And that should make sense because we found that the distance from the origin to this point was the square root of 98, almost the square root of 100, which is 10 to the circle. And finally, we looked at the point 5, 9, this orange point out here. Zooming in, we see that yes, it's just outside of our circle.